In this Getting Started video series, we are going to begin at the point where we have FME installed and we are about to use it for the first time. I encourage you to work along with me by downloading the parks.zip file found on this page. Before we begin, let's take a moment to think about what it is that we are trying to do. Here is some City of Vancouver Parks data in FME's viewing application, the FME Data Inspector. Notice that our area features are in green and that we have a number of attributes on these features. We'll start by opening FME Workbench to create a workspace. This will allow us to translate the parks data to GML, modify its attributes, and reproject the data. Within the Getting Started window, we can click on Generate Workspace. Here, you can tell FME what data format files or databases we are working with. It is important to note that later on, you can add more readers and writers to your workspace. If I select my reader dataset, FME will recognize the dataset extension and automatically set my reader format, which, in this case, is Map Info Tab. For my output writer dataset, if I type GML, FME will prompt me with a list from which I may select the format I want, in this case, Geography Markup Language. I can also click the drop-down list arrow, which will show me the last 10 formats that I have used. By clicking on More Formats, I can view and select from the full formats list. Now, I can browse to an output folder and set the name of the file to write. I'm going to title this .gml file as output. When I click OK, the workspace will be magically created. We can run the workspace by clicking on the Run button in the toolbar. It's also a good habit to get into saving your work as you go. This will allow you to either run the workspace later or share it with another user. I'm going to save this as My First Workspace. I can locate my output.gml file by navigating to the folder in which I saved it to. In the next video, we will modify attributes in the GML data.